Welcome to Real Reviews. I'm your host, Ben. When you think American animated movies, you think either Pixar or Disney. Nowadays, they're technically the same, but I'm not going to give Disney any more free press. Pixar made a splash on the animated scene with Toy Story 1 and 2, they continued it with Bug's Life, Finding Nemo, and in 2004 they released the prelude to today's topic, The Incredibles. It was a massive success since it was simultaneously a parody slash deconstruction of the superhero genre, as well as a masterful superhero movie that wasn't DC nor Marvel. And keep in mind, this was before the two gained their modern cinematic reputations. For 14 years, fans pleaded for a sequel, and in June of 2018, director Brad Bird gave them exactly that. Was it worth the wait? Let's find out. Here is the good, the bad, and the final judgment. Before I talk about the movie, I'm going to take a minute to talk about the pre-film animated short, which is customary for all Pixar films. The short is simply called Bao. It details the story of a Chinese woman who makes an anthropomorphic dumpling by accident, and she names it Bao, who she comes to care for as if it's her own child. She deals with the struggle of the child growing up and eventually leaving the nest. Bao is an example of incredible storytelling, delivering a story without any dialogue and with pure visuals alone. The concept is handled with a heavy amount of respect, and in the hands of a studio like DreamWorks, it would feel like a horrifying fever dream. But it's definitely worthy of being in the top 10 of pre-movie Pixar shorts. Now for The Incredibles 2. Here's a basic rundown of the plot. Incredibles' family get in legal trouble when they fail to stop a minor villain from robbing a bank and go back to square one of being underground. Until a corporate tycoon with a nagging sense of nostalgia attempts to bring superheroes, known as supers in this universe, back into the positive public eye in order to undo the law banning superheroes, starting with Elastigirl. What's the reason? Well, in her adventures before supers were made illegal, she caused the least amount of damage between her and her husband. It turns out the tycoon sister is the one creating chaos in order to smear the reputations of supers because their parents weren't saved by supers, despite being very friendly with the supers. As per tradition of Pixar, the animation is spectacular. The character's movement, facial animations, and lines are lively and uniquely human. Each twitch, blink, and line is delivered in such a way that is worthy of high praise in every aspect. Secondly, the expansion and character growth from the original is incredibly ingenious. Violet becomes more angsty throughout the film and then eventually matures. Dash, it starts out hot-headed and brash and then becomes slightly less hot-headed and brash. Robert, Mr. Incredible, takes a much more domestic role in the family while Elastigirl is saving the world and making the world better for supers. And Helen, Elastigirl, becoming more active in the role in the movie is an incredible breath of fresh air from the previous film, where she only becomes a big part of the narrative in the second half. By far the best aspect of the movie is the youngest bar child, Jack-Jack, and his large assortment powers, all of which are played to brilliant comedic effect. Especially the scene with the raccoon, which is by far the best part of the movie. Even great films have their hiccups, and this movie is no different. The film does suffer from a weak villain, the villainous Evelyn Devor. Yes, her name is literally Evil Endeavor. It's a rather forgettable villain in comparison to Syndrome. Also, her characterization is a little bit lazy, making her the opposite of Syndrome. It essentially has one of the main flaws from Iron Man 3, but by no means are the two films comparable. Also, the sequel does not contain nearly as much of the character Edna Mode as it should have. For those who are unaware, Edna Mode created the super suits for the supers. Sounds like a boring character, I know, but she's one of the best characters. Ever. Yes, you can quote me. The final judgment. Despite shortcomings towards the end, Incredibles is definitely worthy of its sequel. It should go down into the top 10 animated sequel category, showing that Pixar can make more sequels like Toy Story 2 and 3, and less like Cars 2, Cars 3, Planes, and Planes 2. Yes, they made two Cars sequels and two Planes movies, but hey, they can't all be hits.
One of the jury, you reached a verdict.
We have, Your Honor.
Will they defendant please rise and face the jury?
Final rating, 9.5 out of 10. Thank you for joining, and we'll see you next time.
This podcast is part of the Norcast Podcast Network. Check out more podcasts at podomatic.com/norcam.